the new administration, Mr. Harris and Mr. Dial, for their support. The janitors for all the work they do, painting the fields. It's been interesting this year. You know, we're under a financial crisis, and we ran out of paint, couldn't paint the practice field, and I was begging them, hey, you gotta have paint. But they came through for us. Tim Serena is the new janitor taking care of that. He's doing an outstanding job. I'd also like to thank all the churches for feeding this army of boys, and they eat. I'd also like to thank the cheerleaders. Where you at? You guys do an outstanding job. Also like to thank the coaches for all their help. There's a lot of long weekends at Central where we do our film breakdown, and their families for letting them be part of the coaching staff. I'd like to also thank my wife for all the time that she allows me to be gone. She calls herself a football widow. You know, I probably don't buy her enough flowers throughout the course of the year for all of her support, but I got one for you tonight. Who says I'm cheap? I'd also like to thank the football moms for picking up the food for the away games. That's one less thing we have to worry about. And it's funny, this is the first year I remember to thank the water girls. My daughter was the water girl for the last 3 years, and I never thanked her a single time, but I'll thank Ms. Corzine and Ms. Barnes for coming out and helping out. Sorry, Megan. When it comes to this season, it's been a roller coaster ride. Started in the summer, actually started in the spring when I was debating on who the quarterback would be, who I'd really looked hard at. I looked at several different candidates, and I decided on Connor. And I told Connor, I said, listen, you're just a sophomore. I'm going to need you there every day in the summer. Coach, I'll be there. I'll be there. I said, okay, great. So, okay, so in July, we do a lot of 7-on-7s. Our camp is the last week of July. Need you there. I'll be there, Coach. He's there all June. Beginning of July, he's there. So, okay, guys, now we're starting our 7-on-7s. He said, Coach, that's next week. I mean, yeah. He said, I'm not going to be there. What do you mean you're not going to be there? He said, I got to go on vacation with my dad. I said, okay. All right, that's all right. You're just going to be missing one. He said, well, got some more bad news. I said, what? He goes, I'm not going to be there the next week either. I said, you're going to miss all of our 7-on-7s. Why are you not going to be there next week? He said, I'm going on vacation with my mom.
Let me have yours.
That gave me two gray hairs. And the funny story behind that, I'm going to try to keep it short because I know it's hot. So then I'm like, okay, Sam Cooksey, you're going to be the backup quarterback. I'm going to teach you the routes. He's working hard. He's got like 4 days to learn the routes and all that good stuff. Get him all ready, and he throws his arm out. He literally can't move his arm. So then I look. I'll pull the freshman Clark against Carbondale and DeCoin, our first 7-on-7 game. So, needless to say, he did get better, though. He did it for all three of our games, and by the last 7-on-7, he had a lot of success. Had a little bit of swagger to him, too. But that's the start of summer, not to mention, they hired my defensive coordinator as the assistant principal and AD, so I lose that. So then I'm scrambling. We got Coach Patton to help out as a volunteer, and Coach Rhodes rejoined us. So, it's been pretty crazy, to say the least. But I'll tell you what, I can't say enough about this team. We've had a bunch of injuries already this year when it comes to, unfortunately, mainly my senior class. We've had the last couple games, we started basically one senior on offense and two on defense. So we're a pretty young team. We're making mistakes, but we're learning from them, and they're doing a great job. When it comes to homecoming, you know, this is my... got a story to tell you about my daughter, Megan. Right here. It's her senior year, and it takes me back to when she was a freshman. She enters high school. She's my only daughter, so I don't know how all this stuff works, but homecoming comes around, and She didn't get voted out of the homecoming court.
Hashtag out.
I was like, man, come home. You know, I'm not doing anything about the football season. Well, my wife is having a heart to heart with her. Honey, I'm sorry you didn't get voted out of the homecoming court. She goes, oh, it's okay. And I go, well, I'm kind of surprised you didn't get voted out. She goes, I'm not. I said, well, why not? She goes, oh, I told everybody that if you vote for me, I'm going to punch you in the face. I can respect that. But homecoming, the stage looks awesome. Murph, I think you outdid yourself this year. We're playing Vet at home this year. It's going to